Oh, look. There's another team of grave robbers.
Is it another team or is it us, Dieter? I mean, look at them. It's us. It could be us in another timeline.
So, have you discovered the Army of Dead time loop theory yet? First things first, if you haven't watched Zack Snyder's zombie heist epic yet, then what are you doing here? There are many spoilers ahead, so we definitely recommend watching the film before watching this video. It's okay, we'll wait. So, where were we? Ah yes, the time loop. There's lots to dig into in Army of the Dead, whether it's the zombie tiger,
that's crossing the line,
or Dieter screaming. And one fan theory that's setting the Snyder army alight is the idea the team is stuck in an infinite time loop. The theory begins with this scene in the vault, where the group finds some bodies which look suspiciously familiar. The characters brush it off as just another team trying to get to the money. After all, earlier in the film, they also found another set of blueprints.
Let's not get other teams here before us.
But there are some signs it's not just a case of Tanaka sending multiple teams for the same deadly mission.
It could be us in another timeline, and we're caught in some infinite loop of fighting and dying, fighting and dying, fighting and dying. And Tanaka, puppet master, devil, god, and we, you, me, Goose and the rest of the team, simply pawns in some perverse play where we're destined to repeat our failures. And finally, in some mind-bending, ironic reveal, it all begins again.
Vanderhoe is clearly trying to spook zombie newbie Dieter, but there are a few signs that his scary story could ring true in this universe. One of the bodies has a key necklace just like Maria's. Another wears Scott's bandana. Then there's Peters' distinctive Hawaiian shirt. And fans think this whole theory changes the nature of the making the plan montage scene. Could Dieter's dream heist sequence be a peek into a more favourable time loop? Where the gang gets the money and, well, stay alive. Eagle-eyed watchers notice the vault in said montage has three AK-47s leaning against the wall. The gun Guzman uses. Perhaps a sign they've been here before. Fans also think the number of guns in the vault during the dream sequence is important because it could indicate that the crew has been here three times before. That could also be hinted at in this exchange just before they find the bodies.
I shot it three times.
Actually, it was four.
Four.
And what's the big difference between this dream sequence and the events of the film? That would be the inclusion of Guzman's friend.
This is the real plan? It's zombies? Fuck this. I'm out. This is crazy. You all are gonna die.
Jesus Christ.
Sorry, brother.
Amateurs.
Oh, and there's one more thing. The film's epilogue shows us how Vanderhoe escapes a nuked Vegas with the money. Great! Except Zeus seems to have bitten him, and he's about to descend on Mexico City.
Fuck.
But did Zeus bite him? He was about to, but thanks to Dieter, it definitely didn't happen on screen, which makes us wonder, is the epilogue showing us a different timeline in the time loop? Now, only Zack Snyder can confirm or deny if any of this theory is true, and aside from this cryptic tweet with a potential hint to the rule of three we mentioned earlier, he's not giving the game away just yet. So, whatever the answer, maybe the best thing to do is to re-watch Army of the Dead and see if you can spot any more time loop clues. Are there any we missed? For more behind the scenes of your favourite Netflix shows, make sure you subscribe to the channel.